Hey everyone, welcome to my channel. Here I'm doing exercise 2.3 and the question is solve the following equations and check your results. We'll start with the first one. So 3x is equal to 2x plus 18. We have to find the value of x, so we'll transpose 2x to the other side. So this will be 3x minus 2x is equal to 18. So when you subtract it, we'll get x is equal to 18. Now once we got the answer, they have also asked to verify, that is to check your result. So we're going to substitute 18 in the given equation and we'll check LHS and RHS are same or not. So we'll substitute it. So 3 into, in place of x you have to put 18. So 3 into 18 is equal to 2 into 18 plus 18. So 18 into 3 will be equal to 54. Is equal to, and 18 into 2 is 36 plus 18, so this is equal to 54 and this is equal to 54. So we can say LHS is equal to RHS. So it means our answer x is equal to 18 is the correct one. Now we'll go to the second question. So second one is 5t minus 3 is equal to 3t minus 5. In this case, you have to find out the value of t. So I'll transpose 3t to the other side and minus 3 to this side. Like all the variables together and all the constants together. So we'll get 5t. 3t is a positive. When you transpose, it becomes minus. So minus 3t. And minus 3, when we transpose, it becomes plus 3. So 3 minus 5, the sign of 3 is positive. Now this is 2t is equal to minus 2. From here, t will be equal to minus 2 upon 2. When we transpose, the 2 comes in denominator. It is in multiplication. It comes in division when transposing it. We can cancel 2. From here, t value is equal to minus 1. Now we'll check whether the answer is correct or not by substituting in it. So 5 into minus 1. Minus 3 is equal to 3 into minus 1 minus 5. So this is minus 5 minus 3 is equal to minus 3 minus 5. So we'll get minus 8 is equal to minus 8. So LHS and RHS are equal. It means that answer T is equal to minus 1 is the correct answer. Now we'll move on to the third question. So third question is 5x plus 9 is equal to 5 plus 3x. So here we have to find out the x value. So bring all the variables together. So transpose 3x to this side and 9 to the other side. So we'll get 5x minus 3x is equal to 5, and plus 9 when transpose it becomes minus 9. So from here 2x is equal to minus 4. So x will be equal to, now 2 will come in denominator, it is in multiplication, comes in denominator when you transpose. So 2 ones are and then 2. So we'll get x is equal to minus 2. Now we'll substitute here. So 5 into minus 2 plus 9 is equal to 5 plus 3 into minus 2. So this is minus 10 plus 9 is equal to 5 minus 6. So when we do it, we'll get minus 1 here, and then 5 minus 6 is also minus 1. So LHS is equal to RHS. It means the x is equal to minus 2 is the correct answer. Now, fourth question. So fourth question is 4z plus 3 is equal to 6 plus 2z. Now transpose 2z to the other side and we'll transpose 3 to the other side. So it will be 4z minus 2z is equal to 6 minus 3. So this is 2z is equal to 3. We want only z value, so transpose 2 to the other side. So z will be equal to 3 upon 2. Now we cannot cancel this. We'll just keep z value as 3 upon 2. Now we'll verify the answer. So we'll substitute back the number here, 3 upon 2. So 4 into 3/2 plus 3 is equal to 6 plus 2 into 3/2. So 2 and 4 will get cancelled, we'll get 2 here, and 2 3s are 6 plus this 3 is equal to 6 plus, we can cancel 2 and 2, we'll get 3. So 9 is equal to 9. So LHS is equal to RHS. So Z is equal to 3/2 is the correct answer here. Then we'll move on to the fifth question. So fifth one is 2x minus 1 is equal to 14 minus x. Similarly, same thing. Transpose minus x to the one side and minus 1 to the other side. So it becomes 2x minus x will become plus x is equal to 14 minus 1 when you transpose become plus 1. Now this is 3x is equal to 15. So from here x is equal to 15/3. Cancel it, we'll get 5. So x is equal to 5. Now we'll check the answer. So 2 into 5 minus 1 is equal to 14 minus 5. So this is 10 minus 1 and this is 9. And 9 is equal to 9. So LHS is equal to RHS. It means x is equal to 5 is a correct answer. Now we'll move on to the next sixth question. So the sixth problem is 8x plus 4 is equal to 3 into x minus 1 plus 7. First thing is we're going to open the bracket. So we'll get 8x plus 4 is equal to 3x, 3 into x 3x, 3 into minus 1 is minus 3 plus 7. Now this is equal to 8x plus 4 is equal to 3x plus 4. Minus 3 plus 7 is plus 4. Now we'll transpose the number. So 3x comes on the left side and the 4 we're transposing to the other side. So from here we'll get 8x minus 3x is equal to 4 minus 4. So this is 5x is equal to 0. So x value will be equal to 0/5, which will be equal to 0. Now we'll cross check the answer by substituting it. So we have 8 into 0 plus 4 is equal to 3 into 0 minus 1 plus 7. So this is 8 zeros are 0. So we'll just write down 4. And this is 3 into minus 1 plus 7. So 4 is equal to minus 3 plus 7. So 4 is equal to 4. So LHS is equal to RHS. So that's correct. X is equal to 0 is the correct answer. Now we'll move on to the seventh question. So seventh is X is equal to 4/5. Into x plus 10. Now there are different ways of doing it. You can multiply 4/5 with x and then you can just open the bracket, or else we can just transpose 5 to the other side. 5 is in division, we can transpose, it comes in multiplication. So to multiply with x we'll get 5x. Now in here we have only 4, so we'll multiply 4 with x plus 10, so we'll get 4x plus 40. Now we'll transpose 4x to the other side. So we'll get 5x minus 4x is equal to 40. So x value will be equal to 40. Right? Now we'll substitute and check it out if the answer is correct or wrong. So x value is 40. So 40 is equal to 4/5. In the brackets we have 40 plus 10. So 40 is equal to 4/5. In the brackets we'll get 50. Now cancel 5 and 50, we'll get 10. So 4 into 10 is 40. So 40 is equal to 40. It means x is equal to 40 is a correct answer. Now the eighth question. So we have a 2x/3 plus 1 is equal to 7x/15 plus 3. Now we're going to bring the rational numbers, that is 2x upon 3 and 7x upon 15 together, and 1 and 3 together. So we'll transpose a number. So plus 1 will transpose to the RHS and 7x upon 15 to the left hand side. So we'll get 2x upon 3 minus 7x upon 15 is equal to 3 minus 1. Now to solve the left hand part, you have to take a LCM because denominators are not same. We have to make it same by taking LCM. So from here, LCM of 3 and 15 will be 15. So we can write 2x upon 3. With 3 we have to multiply 5 to get 15. So we are multiplying 5 in the numerator also. Minus 7x upon 15. Already 15 is there in denominator, we are not multiplying anything. And this is equal to 2. Now we'll get 10x upon 15 minus 7x upon 15 is equal to 2. So 15 is a common denominator, we'll write 15, and in the numerator 10x minus 7x is equal to 2. So 3x upon 15 is equal to 2. We can cancel 3 and 15, we'll get 5. So we got x upon 5 is equal to 2. Now multiply, just transpose 2 to the other side. It is in division. When we transpose, it comes in multiplication. So 5 2 is up, it becomes 10. So x value will be equal to 10. Now we'll cross check the answer. So we'll substitute the value of x is equal to 10 in the given question. So we'll get here 2 into 10 upon 3 plus 1. In place of x, we'll just substitute 10. So 7 into 10 upon 15 plus 3. So this is 20 upon 3 plus 1 is equal to 70 upon 15 plus 3. We can cancel this in a 15 and 10 in a 5 table. So we'll get 3. And when we cancel 70 and 5, so we'll get 14. Now further calculation, we'll get, so we'll take LCM here, so it will be 3 as a common denominator, we'll get 20 plus 3, and on the other side we'll get 14 plus 9 upon 3. So this is 23 upon 3 is equal to 23 upon 3. So it is verified, LHS and RHS are same, it means x is equal to 10 is the correct answer. Now we'll go to the ninth question. So starting from the next question, that's the ninth one. So we have 2y plus 5 upon 3 is equal to 26 upon 3 minus y. Now we'll transpose y to the other side and 5 upon 2 to this side. So we'll get 2y plus y minus y become plus y is equal to 26 upon 3 minus 5 upon 3. Now this is 3y is equal to, so common denominator 3 is in the denominator, we can directly subtract the numerators, 26 minus 5. So 3y is equal to 21 upon 3. So this 3 comes in the denominator when we transpose it. So we'll get, this is equal to, y is equal to 21 upon 3 into 3, it comes in denominator. So 3 and 27 will get cancelled, 21 will get cancelled. So we'll get y is equal to 7 upon 3. Now we'll cross check the answer by substituting the value in this equation. Now y value we got is 7 upon 3. So 2 into 7 upon 3 plus 5 upon 3 is equal to 26 upon 3 minus 7 upon 3. Now this is 14 upon 3 plus 5 upon 3 is equal to, now denominator is common 3, it's same, so we can just directly subtract the numerators. So here we'll get 14 plus 5 upon 3 is equal to 26 minus 7 is 19, so 19 upon 3, and 14 plus 5 is 19, and 19 upon 3 is equal to 19 upon 3. It means x is equal to 7 upon 3 is the correct answer. Now the next one, it's the last question, 10th one. So the 10th problem is 3m is equal to 5m minus 8 upon 5. So transpose 5m to the other side, we'll get 3m minus 5m is equal to minus 8 upon 5. So this is minus 2m is equal to minus 8 upon 5. Now we'll transpose minus 2 to the other side, we'll get m is equal to minus 8 upon 5 into minus 2. So minus 2 and minus 8 will cancel, we'll get 4. So m value we got is 4 upon 5. Now we'll verify the answer. So in place of m, you have to put 4 upon 5. So 3 into 4 upon 5 is equal to 5 into 4 upon 5 minus 8 upon 5. So this is 12 upon 5 is equal to 20 upon 5 minus 8 upon 5. So on the right hand side, denominator is same. So we'll just subtract it. So 20 minus 8 upon 5. So 20 minus 8 is 12. So we'll write down here. So from here, I'm writing here, we'll get 12 upon 5 is equal to 12 upon 5. So LHS and RHS are equal. It means M is equal to 4 upon 5 is the correct answer. So this is how you should do it. I hope you have understood all the problems. If you have any question or you want to say something, you can just leave a comment below. And thank you so much for watching this.
If you like this video, then subscribe and click on bell icon.